Chicago. Watch who steps out of this big SUV. Here he is, Prince Harry. He is here in the United States. This is day one of a multi-day visit. He is in our nation's capital. Specifically, there he is, Senator John McCain, greeting the senator from Arizona as he continues on in. Let me just give you a little bit of background. The two are about to tour this exhibit. It's sponsored by Halo Trust. It's a group that clears landmines and other dangerous war debris. You remember his mother, Princess Diana, was involved actually with that group before her death in 1997. Let me bring in our royal correspondent, Max Foster, who has taken the trip from London to Washington to follow along with the prince. And Max, give me the details. I mean, why is Prince Harry here? Where is he headed?
Well, twofold, really. He's promoting his own charities, which is what this is about, but also promoting British interests. So, as you say, this is a charity very close to his heart. It was supported by Princess Diana, and he wants to keep her legacy alive, and this is one of the examples of him doing that. So he's going to look around a few of the projects that they've been involved with in this charity. So this is one of the events. Later on, he'll go off to the British Embassy, and he'll meet high-powered political figures here in Washington. But that's really working on behalf of the government, promoting British interests. So it's twofold. You'll see that happening every day. Lots of military involvement as well, Brooke. This is a serving British officer, and he cares deeply about wounded soldiers in particular. So that will certainly be a theme. I'm told that's the backbone of his whole trip. That's what he cares about. And I'm told he's pretty fired up about the whole visit as well, Brooke.
And of course, John McCain, a veteran himself, fitting to be speaking with Prince Harry. So here's the trip in Washington, and we sort of laid that out. But looking down, next up, he is headed on a plane to Colorado. Tell me where he's going.
Yeah, Colorado, that's the Warrior Games. So that's really what he cares most about. It's something that he is very keen on. He's been promoting for some time. It's effectively the Paralympics for wounded soldiers and servicemen and women. And that is what he wants to promote. There's a British team involved for the very first time. There'll be an interesting event tomorrow as well with a military theme, Brooke. Going to Arlington Cemetery, going to the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, laying a wreath there. Also to JFK's burial site as well. And he'll be wearing full uniform, very somber occasion. But there'll be some time for fun as well. A big polo match organized for Connecticut at the very end of the tour. Very glamorous affair. I have to say, young women paying a huge amounts of money for tickets to that event. And this was a pretty extraordinary scene, I have to say. Where we see Prince Harry now, that whole area was circled by women, staffers at the Senate, very keen to see him. And there
Wait,
were crowds
Max,
and crowds
not,
of them.
They're not there for you?
They weren't there for me, unfortunately, but they got cleared out by the police and they look absolutely gutted. Yeah, I mean, this is the guy that can turn women into princesses, of course, Brooke.
I know for the Diamond Jubilee, when he was visiting the Caribbean, you followed along, and I'm sure the scene was similar with Prince Harry. Max Foster, we appreciate you taking the trip over to follow Prince Harry as he heads to Colorado and New Jersey to visit the badly affected area by Hurricane Irene. We know we've heard from New Jersey Governor Chris Christie saying he will keep his eye on him, as we all know sort of what happened last time he was here and that whole Vegas trip. So he will have fun. But perhaps not too much fun. Prince Harry, Max Foster, thank you.